Good afternoon once again, everyone. This is Tube 87, and to those of you who are still keeping the Sabbath, I hope you're having a happy and blessed Sabbath still. Now, I'm going to answer a question that was asked by one of my wife's subscribers, and the question, in a simple sense, was, how do you teach scripture to young children and siblings, making it simple? Well, first, I'm going to say this. No one's ever too young to start learning scripture or the word. Now, what we've done around here, we have a one-year-old and a three-year-old, just turned three, so we have two very young children around here, and they're well on their way to understanding scripture. Some of you may have seen my video with Olivia on it, and she knows the commandments, and so does her brother, Josiah. He's three. Now, what we do and what you have to do is be an example. You have to be an example for anything that you want your children to learn or not learn. You have to be careful of what you're being an example for when they're learning things that are negative. So, with that being said, prayer. Teach your children how to pray. Pray with them when they go to bed. Pray with them when they wake up. Pray with them at meal times. This is one of the easiest ways to instill the Heavenly Father into them. Teach them how to pray. And do it correctly. Teach them how to pray with their hands together and their eyes closed, and pray for specific things when you're saying prayer. If you're praying about food, teach them a prayer. Don't be afraid to be creative in being in creating a sincere prayer. It doesn't have to be one of those nursery rhyme type prayers that are out there that may or may not fit what you're really trying to teach your children. You teach them something sincere and meaningful to pray about. When they go to bed, the same thing. The children around here, they know how to pray. Secondly, you have to be studying the Word. You have to be studying Scripture, reading the Word, living the Word, and they have to see you doing it, and you have to sit them down with you and do it with them. Now, the two young ones around here, they understand the commandments. They know what a Bible is. The one-year-old knows what a Bible is. If she sees it, she knows it's a Bible. I don't have to tell her. She says it's a Bible. If they see the Bible, they get excited. They want to read the commandments. They know the commandments. We read them every week. We read them often. Exodus 20, all the way through, we read all the commandments. And we have been doing it all their lives. And they know them. They have memorized them. Yeah, they can't read the words per se, but they know the scripture. We start reading the scripture from the word. They read right along from their memory. Now, this is a key. All understanding or discernment comes from the Holy Spirit. They're remembering because the Holy Spirit is bringing it back to their remembrance, as He does with us. We have to study. When we study, and it doesn't matter if it's the King James, we don't need a scripture that has been dumbed down into basic, simple English language as if it were a coloring book where you break it down to first grade words. That is changing the Father's word. We are warned about changing His word. Now, so we read scripture to them. We also show them Bible movies. Now, this is important as far as I'm concerned. When it comes to these movies, there's only one group that I would recommend to anyone anywhere, and that is the Bible Collection. This series was made during the 90s. I'm not talking the Ten Commandments with Charlton Heston. Throw it out. There's so many flaws in that. It skims along with what Scripture says. So I would not recommend that. That's a love story. Now, Scripture doesn't talk about a love story when it talks about the Exodus. If you study Scripture, you know that movie has very little to do with what the Word actually says. I recommend the Bible Collection. This series was made in the 90s there. I think there are about 12 movies in that collection. You have Esther, you have Moses, you have David, you have Joseph, Jacob. You have several of the books of the Bible in the movie collection. These run extremely close to Scripture. Now, as you study Scripture, you'll see little things that are different, but these are excellent, as far as I'm concerned, for adults and children alike to follow along and get an extremely good idea of what Scripture is saying. And then as you go back and you read through the Scripture, it recalls the movie to your mind and you see things that may have been left out or may be slightly different. But those movies are extremely close to Scripture, and those hold children's attention a whole lot better than trying to read the book of Genesis to them. But in the same regard, you do it in combination, so they start relating Scripture to the movies and they start understanding. Our children around here, they understand. They see Moses, they get excited. They see David, they get excited. They see Joseph, Jacob. They know it's about the Bible. They know it's about the Heavenly Father. They get excited. If you say, let's read the commandments, they get extremely excited. So what we have to do is study with our children. We have to live what we teach. We have to live what we preach. We have to be that example. Don't be concerned that your Bible is, I'm going to say King James because that's all I would recommend. They can understand through discernment. It's not up to us to dumb down any of the Father's word to make it simple to understand. That understanding comes from the Holy Spirit. So teach it, teach it, teach it, and they will understand it eventually, as will adults. Now, 2 Timothy 2:15 reads, "And that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus." The word tells us, from a child. So start teaching your children, even if you don't think they can understand. That's not your job to make them understand. Your job is to teach them. The Holy Spirit will give them understanding, as will you. And with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is Tube 87. I'm out.